World TV champion, and Ronnie, I know you wanted this extended time period.
Well, not only me. I got a lot of fan mail, and I know a lot of people want to see a rematch. I know I've had two chances already, and this is probably going to be my last. And, you know, there's a lot of money involved here and a lot of prestige in having that belt around your waist, you know, and I think it would be a great Christmas present for myself and some of the fans. And I'm going to tell you something, Gordon. I'm ready, and I'm going to make it count because it might be my last try.
Fair enough. Ronnie Garvin getting set to go to the ring. And we'll be back in just a moment or two to bring you this World TV Championship match. Here's a word.
Ladies and gentlemen, World Championship Wrestling proudly presents the World TV Championship special match, one fall with a one-hour time limit. Introducing first, ladies and gentlemen, the challenger at 240 pounds from Montreal, Canada, the former World TV Champion, Ronnie Garvin! Now, ladies and gentlemen, introducing the World TV Champion, managed by Precious Paul Ellering, 242 pounds, from Freeport, Louisiana, Jake the Snake Roberts!
Reach advantage. A slight weight advantage, not enough to be appreciably different. And they're wasting no time at all in moving in against each other. One fall, 60-minute time limit here on World Championship Wrestling. The World Television Championship on the line. And it's Garvin gathering the first advantage as he brings Jake the Snake Roberts to the canvas. And Ellering very quickly giving some advice out there, and it was... Garvin in trouble momentarily, but now Garvin fighting fire with fire. Only I have a hunch this could turn into a pair six.
No question about that. Looking at two men, both of them are very aggressive, very good wrestlers. Garvin, the former champion, Roberts, the present champion. They both know that there's a lot at stake. To be able to go to England, or to be able to go to Japan, or to go to Saudi Arabia, or the Philippines, where I was here recently, or anywhere in the United States, as the television champion, certainly means a lot of extra money in your pocket, and I can't think of anybody that wouldn't like to have some money in their pocket right now at, well, any time of the year for that matter.
Well, two most important times, I guess, would be right now and at about April 15th. And it's Garvin now pressing his advantage. And so Jake the Snake Roberts finding himself in a difficult posture here. Garvin, I think, in asking for this one fall, 1 hour, I think he believes cardiovascularly he's in a little bit better condition than Roberts.
Well, Ronnie does a lot of running, and he does a lot of swimming, and during the summertime, I know he's an avid skier. He also does hang gliding, I understand. Does a lot of things, very athletic. And I think, as you say, being able to carry Jake just a little bit further than the normal 10 minutes that's allotted for that television championship is going to have to go in Ronnie's favor.
I would certainly think so, and it's Garvin now looking good as Jake the Snake Roberts was back and covering up. And it's Jake the Snake staying away, watching him, trying to draw Ronnie Garvin into his corner. Normally, you would think that Jake the Snake would be perhaps on his bicycle in a 10-minute match, but he can't run for 60 minutes, I don't believe.
Well, there's no way. You know, in the past, several different places, Columbus, Ohio, or Saginaw, Grand Rapids, a couple of different places where we've wrestled, we've seen where Jake the Snake has tried to hold on for that 10 minutes, and then just after that, he even left the ring. Knowing that the worst that could happen is that he'd be disqualified. Well, he said he didn't care. He was concerned more about hanging on to his belt. So I'm sure Ronnie Garvin was thinking of that when he asked for the 60 minutes, because even if Jake gets on his bicycle, he can only ride it so long, and 60 minutes is too long for even Jake the Snake and the mastermind, Paul Ellering, to figure out how to run away. Once again, we're looking at Paul Ellering, who's on the outside. He's giving signals. I don't know what they mean, but obviously there is a set that's set up between he and Jake the Snake. And as I said before, if Ellering is eliminated, you have to wonder how good would the Snake be, how good would the Road Warriors be.
Excellent point. Right now, it's Ronnie Garvin punishing the left arm of Jake the Snake Roberts, the World TV Champion. In case you've tuned in late or just joined us, this is a World Television Championship match, one fall, with a 60-minute time limit here on World Championship Wrestling. And in the event, we do have to cut away for a commercial message before a pinfall or a submission hold takes place. We will be taping it, so we'll bring it back to you on instant replay. Ellering now continuing to issue instructions to Jake the Snake Roberts as Ronnie Garvin keeps that hammerlock. The more pressure he puts on that, the less circulation in the arm and the less effective that arm becomes.
Well, it's a strategy that Gene and I used to use again, and that is to immobilize one part of the body, try to render it helpless, although right there, Snake is using the leg. And he's a smart wrestler. He's apparently been listening to Ellering again because they detected some kind of a weakness in Garvin's defense, and he was able to come out of a situation where he was in trouble and turn it to his advantage. He's still holding on to his arm.
Right now, though, Ronnie Garvin's got some problems with that leg, and Jake the Snake going back after that left leg, punishing those femoris muscles, that hamstring and the knee. And so Garvin... And that may have been Ellering's long suit here, figuring that perhaps Garvin had the advantage in the cardiovascular area, the stamina area. Is take away then one of those main supports, just like a table. You take away a leg and the table goes down.
That's exactly right. And of course, when you're looking at Ronnie Garvin, it's hard to pick a point that you'd want to weaken. I mean, there's nothing to, looking at his body, there's no particular point to start with that's weaker than the rest. He's got very, very strong legs. He's very heavily built in the lower portions of his body, and yet he's got tremendous arms and shoulders and chest and back muscles. So it's just kind of a toss-up, I think. I don't know why they chose the leg or what their strategy was, but that's where they went, and right now, but Ronnie's still fighting.
Firing back, three shots right to the chest. But I think they're trying to take away Garvin's speed. I think they're trying to slow him down so that Jake the Snake is not going to have to expend as much energy. Single leg pickup by Garvin. Lateral press. Jake the Snake powers out. But Garvin is having trouble with that knee. He's having trouble with the knee, and it is Jake the Snake right back after the leg again, punishing the knee again, and it is beginning to take its toll. And there you see Ellering issuing instructions to Jake the Snake, and right away Jake the Snake goes back after that left leg. I think that's the whole idea, is try and slow Garvin down so that he cannot tire Snake Roberts out.
Well, it sure looks that way. Certainly if you take the leg, it's probably more dangerous to have the leg gone. You'd be in greater trouble if the leg was immobilized than an arm. And apparently that's the way Ellering felt and Roberts felt, because we're seeing the effects of it. If you don't have that leg, well, then you don't stand up. If you don't stand up, you're not able to punch either. So maybe there was some good strategy and a lot of thought put into that. And right now it looks as though it's working.
It appears to be indeed. And that knee may be more severely damaged than we imagined, because a moment ago we saw the pain crossing the face of Ronnie Garvin. And Garvin, that leg is being stretched and pulled now by Jake the Snake Roberts. And Garvin is not moving effectively now. He is not moving effectively. So it could be a cartilage or a ligament, or it could be, and it is Garvin pointing to that leg and pointing to that knee. Garvin in considerable trouble here. And it appears that Ellering's strategy may be paying off. There you can see it. Great shot by our camera crew and director Skip Ellis. Garvin! Caught him with a good smashing right hand and a headbutt that Jake the Snake after that leg again. And again. atomic knee drop on the knee. And Garvin, pain ripping through his body now. That knee. And what could happen here is we could have some move, some sort of desperation move now by Ronnie Garvin. And this is where he has to be doubly cautious and doubly careful. Jake the Snake. And he is completely concentrating only on that leg and on that knee. And it's Garvin now. A good toehold on Jake the Snake. And we may have reached a stalemate here. Jake the Snake back punishing the leg, and it is Garvin. And you see a bit of frustration now crossing the face of Paul Ellering. Garvin keeping that toehold. Garvin turning into his man. And Garvin catches him with a hard right hand. Garvin back on his feet, and Garvin pounding away. Garvin explodes to the midsection once again. Garvin explodes to the top of the head. Another one that drops Jake the Snake Roberts onto the canvas. Garvin catches him with another stinging right hand. Garvin has set another stinging right hand. And brother, he can handle his dukes, I'll guarantee you that. He catches him again in the top of the head. All right, it's Garvin catching Jake the Snake Roberts in the pit of the stomach coming in. And it's Jake the Snake Roberts. All right, it is Garvin continuing to battle on it. And I'll tell you what, we're going to have to take a short break here. If anything should happen during this break period, we'll bring it back to you in instant replay. We'll be back in just a moment. And neither man has been able to score a pinfall or a submission hold, but it is Ronnie Garvin battling his way back with a full body slam now on Jake the Snake Roberts. And it's Garvin crashing down across the chest of Jake the Snake Roberts. The World Television Championship on the line, and Garvin punishes him once again. Jake the Snake had a foot up on the ropes. That forces the break. Garvin back to his feet. Garvin explodes with one into the throat. High, high backdrop, but that took its toll on Ronnie Garvin's knee as well. Again, it is Garvin driving the elbow. And again, Jake the Snake foot on the ropes. And so the referee calls for the break, but Garvin punishing him a little bit on the break. And Garvin having a lot of problems with that knee. And I don't know that Jake the Snake's gonna get up from this one. His foot's on the ropes, and he's calling it, but Paul Ellering over there making sure that foot got up on the rope. And it is Garvin arguing the point, and Jake the Snake Roberts takes advantage of that situation. Beautiful high knee lift by Roberts that puts Garvin to the canvas. Lateral press, and Garvin powering his way out as Jake the Snake Roberts tried for a pinning combination. Roberts using that elbow very effectively to the side of the head. Or Snake Roberts, rather, using it very effectively to the side of Garvin's head. And it is Garvin in a lot of trouble here. Staggered again. Garvin trying to get it together. Jake the Snake Roberts seems to be very much in control here. Jake the Snake belly to back suplex. Garvin down, and Jake the Snake. And again, Garvin powers out. Garvin with great, great second effort here. It's Jake the Snake, a boot to the midsection. He's got it. Tried a rolling reverse. Jake the Snake fired with a hard right hand. And Jake the Snake being warned by the referee. Garvin still on the canvas. And Jake the Snake. Ooh, drove that knee right into the side of the rib cage. Drives the knee into the rib cage once again. And so they have been taking away the stamina, the lasting power. And again, Garvin powers out, utilizing his legs. He has powered out on three separate occasions. Now fires to the midsection, fires again to the midsection. A third time, and it's Garvin with lefts and rights now to the abdominal structure. And one to the side of the jaw that staggers Robertson, a rabbit punch. Another one across the head. Ronnie Garvin. Brother, you talk about great second effort. He's got it. He drives Jake the Snake Roberts into the turnbuckle and catches him with a series of rights and lefts into the side of the rib cage and into that abdominal wall, one to the top of the head. Another one to the side of the jaw. What happened there? Ellering over in that corner. It was difficult to tell. Garvin caught on the side. Another full slam. He's got his foot on the rope. Had his foot on the rope. Jake the Snake. Another full slam. And again. Ellering holding that foot down. Ellering held that foot down. As far as I could tell, a judgment call on the referee's part. The referee, I don't believe, could possibly see what was happening. It was very difficult to tell from this vantage point. But it appears, at the moment at least, that Snake Roberts retains his World Television Championship.